Last time, we have seen how to test those LEDs. Today, let's look underneath that yellow coating and check how they are made. Before getting started, just to get a sense of the size we are dealing with. The LED is 3.5 millimeters long and 2.8 millimeters wide. I have a camera placed in front of it and during the complete operation, I can almost see nothing of what I'm doing. This should be fun. Also, I had done no pre-research. Have not looked at any theories or pictures. So I'm starting the adventure absolutely blank. I completed a couple of runs. And at this stage, I was pretty confident. But I was in for a big disappointment when reviewing the videos. Just two naked pads. No wires. No components. Nothing. Nothing. Same for the burnt LED that I marked in red. Just a little sign of overheating. But nothing else. My eyes fell at this stage on the piece of yellow coating that was just ejected. Something was shining in there. And on the other ones too. Okay. This called for more investigation of that little tiny shiny thingy. But now, I need to be gentle. I need more finesse. Time to try a few different techniques. Another attempt was made by collecting with a sticky tape all the microscopic debris on my workbench. There again I could spot something of interest, but could not get a clear shot of it as it was laying on the wrong side. I thought this had been a complete failure. But when I reviewed again my initial first test run video, I made a surprising discovery. Check this out. Did you see that? So, we have it, folks. What's inside an SMD LED? Under the phosphor yellow coating. Two tiny bond wires start from each pad and connect to the LED chip, which, when submitted to the right voltage and the right amount of current, produces light. A tiny light bulb. And at this scale, to me, that is amazing.